In this video, we're gonna do XLOOKUP that gets us multiple columns using a single formula. Let's just start with a basic example. And by the way, this will work both in Excel and Google Sheets, so it should be compatible for both. So if I just start with a basic XLOOKUP here, so lookup value is gonna be, let's say this VIN number, comma. Now as a lookup array, I'm gonna go to this other tab here, and I'm gonna select this column of VIN numbers here, comma, and then here we have return array. Now return array, if I just wanted, let's say color, I could just click this column E, and if I close parentheses, hit enter, that of course gives me the color. If I want to get multiple columns, one thing I can do here, when I get to this return array, what I could do, I could go back to that other tab, and instead of just selecting one column, I can select multiple columns like this. And as a result, if I close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see we get multiple results from that. Now, of course, at this point, you can just take this formula and drag it down and get your results. And all of this seems like a great idea until you realize that a lot of times when you do this, you don't have all the columns nicely right next to each other that you want to pull. And then the other problem with this is that if somebody later decides to add a column someplace here in your table, then once you go and take a look at your formulas, it will have that included as well. And actually, most of the time, you really probably don't want all the columns. You just need some specific columns. So let's talk about how we're gonna do that. So what I'll do, I'll get rid of this, and I'll also get rid of that extra column over here. So let's say I want 3 out of these 4 columns, and I want them in a particular order. I want color first, then I want model, then I want make. So for that, I'll go here and I'll do equals XLOOKUP again. Once again, I'm gonna point to this VIN number, comma. As a lookup array, I'm gonna go to car info. And again, I'm gonna select that A column. Comma again, this is where I have to do return array. And for return array, what I'll do, I'll use hstack function. And this will allow me to select separate columns from this data. So I'm gonna select color first, comma, then model, comma, and then make. So those columns in that particular order. So I'm gonna close parentheses, and you can see up here, this is hstack, closing parentheses. I need another closing parentheses for XLOOKUP, of course. And if I'd enter, there it is. We got those columns in that particular order. If I take this formula and I drag it, you'll see that I get my results, and sometimes I get NA when there's no match. And of course, if you don't like those NAs, you can go back here and add a comma right here, right before the last parentheses here, and just do double quotes for blank. And with this formula, if I drag this new formula, I should be getting my results. Now this same formula, if I just copy this, hit escape, go back to Google Sheets, and we just paste it here. I hit enter, see, that gives me the results, the same exact way. If I drag this formula, the same exact thing, we get our results, our multiple columns from a single formula. Now, one thing in this formula that may not be very efficient is that I selected this entire column for this lookups, and that typically is not a great idea in general. So to make sure you have faster working formulas, you may want to use tables instead of selecting entire columns like this. And just to give you an example, what I could do, I could go to this car info and select this data, control A. I'm gonna go insert table, the third button here, and that has headers, the first row. I'm gonna press OK. And now it's a table, another table design here. We have a name for this table. This is called table one. I'm just gonna call this one car info as one word. That's the name of this table. And because now I have a table, I should be able to refer to columns in that table instead of selecting the entire column. And that looks like this. So I could go here. Now here, instead of this column A, which used to be this VIN numbers, instead of selecting the whole column A, I'm gonna select that column from this table right here, which is VIN column from this car info table. And then here, E column, that's the color, so that will be replaced with this. And then here, C column, I'm gonna replace that with a model. And then of course, for B column, I'm gonna select make like this. And if I hit enter and I copy this down, you'll see I get the same result, but this is gonna be just faster formula because we're not linking to the whole column in a spreadsheet. We're just using the data range from that particular table. And now that we have tables available in Google Sheets too, we should be able to do the same thing in Google Sheets. So if I go to Google Sheets and take this car info, select the whole thing, Command A again, go to format and convert to table. I'm gonna name this table. See, it's called table one. I think I did car info in Excel. So that's the name of the table. I'm gonna press enter. So now we got car info table and these are the columns. And if I go back to Excel now and copy that same exact formula, hit escape, go back here, I should be able to go to this spreadsheet and simply just paste that same formula because the name of the table is the same, car info, column names are the same. That should return the same results. The difference being is that this is just gonna be a faster formula. And there you go. That's how you return multiple columns from XLOOKUP formula. And that should do it. Thanks for watching. Like the video and let me know if you have any suggestions for maybe better alternatives to this. And I'll see you in the next video.